Hello, and welcome to From the Mic Stand. We are live once again at MASH in Macclesfield, here on Otsekos. I'm Mike Chisholm, and on the show each week, we like to interview some of the most interesting up-and-coming artists around, and this week is no different. This week on the show, we're joined in the studio by Lewis Hallam. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, good, good. How's your day been today? It's been alright?
Alright, pretty quiet.
Yeah?
I've been pretty ill, so...
That's a shame.
Yeah, just chilling out, really.
So, as you're a new artist to the show, it'd be great if you could just introduce yourself, tell us a bit about yourself.
I'm Lewis Hallam, I'm 19 years old, and I'm a singer-songwriter from Macclesfield. I'm currently writing at the moment, so I'm hoping to bring up some new music soon, but
yeah.
For now it's just, you know, trying to find gigs and like looking for some work at the moment. So.
Sure.
And anything that I can, you know, sort of get in the music business.
So I think the best way to introduce a new artist is with a live song. So we're going to start things up.
I'm gonna start you off with a B-side to an Oasis single called It's Good to Be Free.
Hey, great. One of you. Great track from Lewis Hallam there. We're going to have a couple more songs from him in a moment, but first I just want to ask you a couple of questions. So when you were first getting on stage and performing, is there anyone in particular that inspired you to get on stage and pick up a guitar?
My inspiration sort of like start from like being really, like, really young.
Yeah.
So I've been obsessed with like the Beatles and Led Zeppelin since like young ages of like four and stuff, like just my granddad, like I had like quite a big bond with music with my granddad. So
yeah,
I've pretty much most of my inspiration sort of range from like, you know, listening to his old records and stuff like that. Mm. So yeah, I'd say like John Lennon's definitely a massive influence. Like Jimmy Page, you know, Led Zeppelin, Pink Floyd, Tame Impala,
sure.
Like Kevin Parker.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sort of inspired from all different genres, but yeah, I'd say mainly going up, you know, at the moment doing open mic nights is kind of, yeah.
And when you're writing your own material, is it mainly from other songwriters, or is it a whole host of influences that draw you into your own material?
I'd say a whole loads of influences. I'd say like the, like if, you know, if I'm going to sit down with my acoustic guitar and try and write like an acoustic ballad, I'd sort of like try and channel like me, you know, John Lennon or like, you know, Noel Gallagher, that kind of like basic, you know, sort of, you know, like their kind of acoustic tracks and stuff. But if I was going for something maybe a bit more rocky, I'd sort of go towards like something like, say, slightly psychedelic, so maybe Led Zeppelin, Black Sabbath, Cream, Jimi Hendrix, like, you know, look towards them. And, yeah, see what happens. I like playing with effects if it's
it's,
you know, if it's like like, you know, complete rock, like rock and roll on stage and stuff like that. I like to play with effects.
Because I was listening to your EP and it had lots of like other elements on it, loads of little effects and like, little bits from other songs on it as well.
Well, at the time I was massively inspired by Kevin Parker. Tame Impala. It's like a solo, you know, he's like a solo artist, but sort of comes across as a band. He mixes, records, produces everything himself, and like going into that EP, that was kind of the goal, to try and like you know, record, mix, and produce all something all by myself. But it was sort of like completely new grounds for me.
Right.
I'd never like properly recorded any music or anything like that. Or I mean, even like properly wrote songs in like, you know, in a format and had it all planned out for like how I want it to sound. And yeah, it was like, you know, yeah, I mean, that was pretty much
that
project.
Couple more songs for me.
I want to play you Bittersweet Symphony by the Verve. Ready? For the next one, I'm going to do Black and Gold by Sam Sparrow. It was a one-hit wonder back in like 2008, I think, or something like that. Anyway.